Harman Infinity Lab is a well-known brand of digital accessories. And today, we got an Infinity Lab 100W 2A2C GaN charger, which has a smaller size and better performance. Let's take it apart. The Infinity Lab logo, product name, charger, and prong icons are on the front of the box. The charger, a storage bag, and the three replaceable prongs are in the package. They are the American standard, European standard, and British standard prongs. The charger is gray and frosted and printed with 100. The center area of the prong side is yellow with the Infinity Lab logo. The spec info is on the bottom. The model is ILINC100W. It can support up to 100 watts and has passed many certifications. It also supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.8 amps, and different outputs of USB-A and USB-C. You can pause to take a look. It has two USB-A ports, two USB-C ports, and a LED indicator. The size is about 87.83 by 66.58 by 34.66mm. The weight of the charger with American standard prongs is about 253 grams. The Charger Lab Power ZKT002 finds that the USB-A port supports the Apple 2.4 amps protocol. The other USB-A port is the same. The USB-C port supports the PD3.0 protocol and 5 fixed PDOs of 5V 3A, 9V 3A, 12V 3A, 15V 3A, 20V 5A. The other USB-C port is the same. Either USB-C 1 and C2 can support up to the maximum output separately. Now, let's take it apart and see what's inside. First, use a spudger to pry along the gap. The connector is a separate module, soldered by wires and insulated by heat-shrink tubing. Then, remove the PCBA module. The PCBA module consists of an output PCB and a main PCB. The output PCB is soldered with a receptacle and a secondary box circuit. The time delay fuse is 5 amps, 250 volts. The blue varistor from Songtian Electronics 10D511K is for overvoltage protection. Here is the common mode choke. The safety X2 capacitor is from WQC, 0.33 microfarads. The secondary common mode choke is wound with flat copper wire and fixed with adhesive in the middle. Two bridge rectifier from Pingwei TBMR610 form the half bridge circuit and are in parallel. Two film capacitors and a magnetic ring inductor form a filter circuit to power the PFC circuit. And the two film capacitors are 0.47 microfarads, 450 volts. The filter inductor is wrapped with copper tape and fixed by a heat-shrink tubing. The PFC boost controller is from NXP Semiconductors TEA19162. The GaN FET for PFC is from GaN Systems GS065011L and printed with GS65111L. It's 150 milliohms, 650 volts, and in the PDFN5x6 package. The PFC rectifier from Pingwei ES5JGR is a 5A diode. The sampling resistor for PFC is 150 milliohms and in a 2512 package. The PFC boost inductor and LLC transformer are on the same PCB with L2 and T1 marked on the top, respectively. The two high voltage capacitors for PFC output filtering are from JSH. It's 420 volts, 39 microfarads. The master control chips are two LLC controllers. They form a half-bridge resonant circuit to improve power conversion efficiency. Two LLC MOSFETs are from Semihao HCFL65R210. It's an NMOS of 650 volts, 200 milliohms, and is in a DFN8x8 package. The LLC resonant capacitor is 0.022 microfarads and 630 volts. Diodes are on the back of the transformer's PCB. The filter capacitor, 35 volts, 47 microfarads. The SMDY capacitor is from TRX TMY1102M. This is the 1009 optocoupler for voltage feedback. The two synchronous rectifiers are from Hongtech. It's an NMOS of 100 volts, 8 milliohms, and is in a DFN5 multiply 6 package. The secondary synchronous rectifier controller is from NXP Semiconductors, TEA1995T. It has two drivers for synchronous rectification of the LLC topology. Two solid filter capacitors from JSH are 820 microfarads, 25 volts. Four MLCCs in the 1206 package and the solid capacitors are in parallel. This is the output filter inductor. A 220 microfarads, 25 volts filter capacitor follows the filter inductor. A bulk inductor is on the back of the USB PCB for the 5 volts output of the two USB-A ports. The USB PD IC adopts the Weltrin WT6636F. The USB-C port adopts a synchronous bulk converter from Toll Microelectronic TMI22A6D. It's 30 volts in the SOP8 package. The other USB-C port is the same. The MOSFET from Hongtech HTM200P03 is to reduce the output voltage drop. It's a PMOS of 30 volts, 20 milliohms, and in a DFN3 multiply 3 package. The output solid filter capacitor is 220 microfarads, 25 volts. The other two used for input and output are also 220 microfarads, 25 volts. The VBUS MOSFET from ARK is printed with 30N5P0S. It's an NMOS of 30 volts, 4.2 milliohms, and in the PDFN3333 package. The other VBUS MOSFET is the same. The bulk controller for two USB-A ports is from Southchip SCA002. The input filter capacitor is 150 microfarads, 25 volts. Two synchronous bulk MOSFETs from Huayi Microelectronics are between the two USB-A ports. It's an NMOS of 30 volts, 7.1 milliohms, and in a DFN3 multiply 3 package. The bulk inductor is fixed with adhesive and wound by two wires. The USB-A ports adopt the SMEI CW3005F IC and support Apple 2.4 amps protocol. There are the sampling resistor and the LM321 operational amplifier for output power distribution control. There are the other sampling resistor and LM321 operational amplifier. The filter capacitor for USB-A port output is 150 microfarads, 6.3 volts. The other USB-A port has the same filter capacitor. The thermistor is covered with heat shrink tubing and insulated with heat-resistant tape. Well, that's all components of the InfinityLab 100W GaN charger. This charger comes with replaceable prongs of three standards, compatible in different countries. It also has two USB-C ports supporting 100W and two USB-A ports supporting 5V, meeting the needs of different devices. Besides, it adopts powerful GaN components to make it smaller and better. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!